3, 2, 1. Hello, welcome or welcome back. Thanks for watching. I am doing a quick unboxing. This is a longer video. This is my Melody Susie that Paige sent me. Thank you, Paige. Shout out Paige Nails. This is the Melody Susie drill, and I'm going to be trying out for the first time in this video. And I was so giddy. I had to fast forward it because I was just so clumsy. And I'm like, oh, here's everything it comes with. And the handpiece, oh my god, I'm in love with the handpiece. Look, right there, I was like, oh, it's so small, it's like a pencil. Compared to my other handpiece, oh, this is like half the size, it's so comfortable. And here I'm like, oh, let's use this drill bit. It did not come with the box, but for what I'm going to do, I needed a course. I'm going to do a removal fill and add some nails to this gorgeous little hand. But thank you, Paige, again. Oh my gosh, I love it so much. It's so compact. And I did not realize how my drill was so old. I guess I just got used to how it was functioning, because I can feel the difference with this new drill. Oh my gosh, it's like, I don't know how to explain it. It works. It does not make, it's not a loud sound. I think I have it on 15 for this removal process. And it feels like nothing. Like, it's so light. I was actually kind of shocked after like the application and everything. And with the cuticle when I do the, because we do prep in this one. Not a lot of prep, but we do prep. Right now I'm removing this old set. And you see the growth? Yeah. It's been 3 weeks now for this set for her. And so, yeah, that's what we're doing. We're going to remove this set, reshape, add the missing nails. I think she's missing 5. 3 on one hand, 2 on another. And that's what we are going to be doing in this video. I'm trying to get it as thin as possible because I know I want to go in with the Bomb Nail Bombshell Pink. She's not a pink girl. She don't like pink for anything. Oh, before I get into that, she has still the, what is that? A bee? I think it's a bee or some type of, like, flying animal. Anyways, to remove those and make it just easier myself, I always file around it, get everything as much as I can off, and boom, it pops off. And there goes the heart, too. So, I removed the stones. I'm like, let me see your other hand. Do you have any? Of course she didn't, because she didn't have no nails left over there that had the charms. So we're just gonna continue removing. I'm trying to get it as thin as possible. Again, not so much that I give her a heat spike or anything, just thin, because it is a darker nude. It is called tan, and it is fairly dark. Like, I really do like it, but and like I said, it's dark, so I was trying to get it as thin as possible. That way when I built up, it wouldn't be a super thick, clumpy nail. And she normally don't like pink. Like, I'm surprised she let me use this color on her. And she's loved the set so far. Like, even she's shocked that she liked it. So I told her it's good to get out of your comfort zone sometimes and try something different that you wouldn't typically try. And I'm glad she trusted me in the process. Like, I did let her have a say. And I think I would try to bring you guys in to see how I do her cuticle work. And right now, I'm just trying to minimize the amount of hand filing I'm going to have to do to reshape. So I'm using the bit to kind of file it down a bit. And yes, I don't know why I'd done it on one hand and one hand I didn't. I thought of it, obviously, last minute. And look at all that work go. There's something satisfying of getting rid of it, too. Like, it's satisfactory, like, when it's a new set, you're, like, so giddy over it. But then when it's old and grown out and watching it go, there's so much satisfaction in that. I mean, I don't know if anyone else knows what I'm talking about. I'm sorry, for whatever reason, the thumb's out of frame. But I'll let you watch, and, well, I was gonna go, but I realized I'm at dusting off, yes, I dust off my drill bit, like, I'm like, no, I cannot get this new drill dirty so quickly, please let me clean it. So, that's what I did. Now I'm going to push back her cuticles, and I'm going to use the mandrel bit, the sanding band, to file the new growth and prep her nails. And I'll go in with my dehydrator and primer, but I will let you guys watch. And if anything, I will jump back in. Okay, so I'm going to start sanding the nails down and getting rid of the cuticle. I do trim the cuticles once in a while, but I don't do it too often because I feel like it makes it grow back thicker. And also, it's just, I don't know, I guess when I'm in the mood, I'll trim it, and when I'm not, I won't. Because, like I said, I honestly feel like, oh, sorry, my knuckles are in the way. I'm shaving down her nail with the drill bit. And all this is real time. I didn't speed this up. I just zoomed it in so you could see the cuticle work and filing all that off. The red on her fingers is from Cheetos. So I try to get what I can off, but yes. Oh, here's where I decide I'm going to shape. I'm going to use the e-file to shape this hand because I already done the other hand. And I thought it might be easier and faster just to pre-shape and less product, honestly, because if I go in now with this shape, then when I go in with the acrylic, I'm going to use more product, and I'm going to have to, me it's just a waste, because I'm going to have to shape it and file all that product off, and it just didn't make sense to do that, so I kind of tried to pre-shape her now. And I'll let you watch the rest of the process. I do end up speeding up some parts of it, but like the first bit of laying the acrylic, I left it in real time, and then I cut some pieces out because it was just a bad angle. This finger, I asked her if she's sure she wanted to get her nails done, because I don't know if you've seen earlier in the video, I was pointing at her finger and pressing on it, because I don't know, the skin underneath the nail where she, like, damaged her nail, and it's growing back out, it just seemed irritated, so I'm like, are you sure? I mean, I can just file them off, and we can give your fingers a rest and let them breathe for a week or so, and she's like, no. I'm used to having nails on. I want my nails done. So, that's just what I'm doing. I'm going based off her. So, I'll let you enjoy this part. And then, if anything, I'll jump in later.
Thank you.
Okay, so I sprayed her hands with alcohol to get the dust off and pre-dehydrate the nails, I guess. And I went in with the dehydrator, my Mia Secret dehydrator. And now I'm going to go in with my Mia Secret Extra Bond primer. And then we'll glue on these tips and cut them down. But so far that's what we've done, and I hope you've enjoyed so far. I also wanted to add that when you are doing the dehydrator and the primer, be careful as to not get it on your skin. You can develop an allergic reaction. It does sometimes happen over time, or, you know, it just kind of depends on you, but you want to be real careful not to get it on the hands you're working on or your own hands. But back to the process, we are gluing on these nails, and I'm going to use my Mia Secret Clear just to kind of seal the nails I'm gluing on right now. Of course, before that, I'm going to cut them down and finish gluing them on, but just to let you know what's happening as it happens, and because I don't bring it in the screen, figured I would mention that. Just don't say it's love, you know it ain't sweet enough. Just don't say it's love, I've heard this shit too much. Just don't say it's love, and don't say, don't say, don't say. Don't say, don't say, don't say. I know it drives you crazy, 'cause I don't ever stay home. And you've been calling me lately, but I don't ever pick up my phone. A couple weeks on the road. Ooh, oh, oh. You say you understand, but you don't.
I tried to scream, but my voice was gone. And they stole every part of me I used to own. I was taken to another world. Couldn't find any of my fears or hopes. I became
never been before.
so on the ring, this is Ice Baby. I know I've told you the pink I'm using is called Bombshell by Bomb Nails. This is also a Bomb Nails product. I was just moving the finger, admiring how beautiful it is. The shift. I ordered this. I do have a reason, other than the fact that it's beautiful. A fun fact is, I don't know if it's considered oversharing, but I call my child Icy. When I was pregnant with him, I loved eating the slush puppies and a bunch of ice and Icy's. That's all I could handle. So that's where his nickname came from. Somebody very special to me told me, your baby is going to come out frozen like ice because you eat so much. So, Ice Baby. It just seemed right, and it goes with his name, so. But let's get back into this nails stuff. This is Bombshell, and it's on, you see, just a tip is no color underneath like the other nails. I was going to add on the pinky and pointer and the other nails that have the color underneath, but my daughter, she really liked the blend. As she said, it reminded her of a sunset or a sunrise, and she really liked that, so we opted to leave that undertone of what turned out to be kind of like an orangey brown undertone. But you can see Bombshell, like, it can be built up, can be darker than this. I really do like it a lot. She liked how it looked like that. She said it looked naturally ombre'd with the nude tip. I don't disagree, it looks freaking awesome. I love it. And I'm gonna go in. I'm draining off when my brush goes out of frame, I'm draining off the excess monomer, because this brush does hold way too much monomer, like more than I need for these small nails or short nails. So I'm just patting it down and blending it onto the nail, making sure everything has some of the pink on it, and then I'll go in with a cuticle bead and build up the color more towards the back, so it goes from that pink to what she calls the sunset. And I'm just patting and pulling, and then wiping off excess. But I'll let you enjoy this and come back later. Okay, so we are at the point of, I think we're going to go in and clear cap. Yes, we are. But look how well they blend, the pink blends into the nude that already existed. Yes, it was my preference to cover it. That's why I filed it down. I didn't want it to be thick. But look at Ice Baby. Gosh, it's so gorgeous. I truly do think that pink blends with anything. Like, I think anything can be blended with it. It works so well. Like, it can be true pink, like, on the thumb and middle finger. Sorry, that's how I put up my brush. I don't know why I left that in there. We're going to seal the cuticles now. This is an extra fine bit I'm using. It is a panna bit I got from Amazon. I'll try to link it in the description box if you're interested. And I'm sealing the cuticles. I don't know if I use the bit to finish shaping. I know I go in with my hand file. Now you're getting a peek of what design she's chose to put on her nails. But mainly I'm sealing the cuticles. There's not a lot of, like, over the top filing. Yes, it is best to file it just to make sure everything is smooth and there's no divots or anything. But I'm going to go around, seal her cuticles. Sorry, I was sneezing right here. That's why I stopped. If you see me pausing for whatever reason, I've been sneezing a lot. I don't know what's going on. It's really rainy and the weather's been bad. So I don't know if that's playing a role in it, but yeah. If at any point you see me pausing, I've tried to remove it all, so sorry. We're just gonna seal these cuticles and try to shape these nails buff, and we're almost to the end. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. Stay blessed, and I will see you on the next one. Thank you. Okay, to finish all this off, we're just gonna put on some stickers and top coat. Those flowers, I didn't know she wanted to use them until we had already finished the design. We started to file at some point, and she told me she wanted to use the flowers. I told her they're supposed to be encapsulated. She's like, no, just put them on like that. So what you see there is my foil gel, and that is what I used to kind of glue them down and then seal them in with some top coat. This first one was not a big success, but it is fine. I ended up kind of slightly bending them to fit on the nail and sealing them in with a top coat, and they've held up just fine. I mean, nothing different than a charm, so yeah, I'll let you finish watching. I hope you've enjoyed, and see you on the next one.